We're going to begin in Washington, where the House is set to hold former Trump Chief of Staff Mark Meadows in contempt of Congress for refusing to cooperate with the committee probing the January 6th insurrection. As committee members reveal text messages he received that day from the president's inner circle and anchors on Fox News. Chief Washington correspondent John Carl starts us off. Good morning, John.
Good morning, George. Today, Congress is poised to do something it has never done before, hold one of its former members in criminal contempt. And in the process, the January 6th committee has revealed startling new details about what people closest to the former president were doing as the Capitol was under attack. Mark Meadows was chief of staff during the final days of the Trump presidency, privy to the actions of the former president and his inner circle as rioters stormed the Capitol. Now the January 6th committee wants the House to hold him in criminal contempt because he is refusing to answer questions about any of it.
No one is above the law, not even a former president's chief of staff.
Before refusing to cooperate, Meadows had turned over thousands of documents, including text messages and emails on his personal cell phones. Liz Cheney, the top Republican on the committee, says that some of them are from the president's own son, pleading with Meadows to get his father to call off the riot.
Quote, he's got to condemn this ASAP. The Capitol Police tweet is not enough, Donald Trump Jr. texted. Meadows responded, quote, I'm pushing it hard. I agree. Still, President Trump did not immediately act. Donald Trump Jr. texted again and again, urging action by the president. Quote, we need an Oval Office address. He has to lead now. It has gone too far and gotten out of hand, end quote.
Cheney also disclosed text messages she says were from Fox News hosts to Meadows as Trump supporters rampaged inside the Capitol. Sean Hannity suggested, quote, can he make a statement asking people to leave the Capitol? Laura Ingraham writing, Mark, the president needs to tell the people in the Capitol to go home. This is hurting all of us. He is destroying his legacy. Also among the 9,000 pages of communications Meadows handed over to the committee were emails showing that prior to January 6th, Meadows told an unnamed associate, quote, the National Guard would be present to protect pro-Trump people. But after turning over those messages and much more, Meadows decided to refuse to cooperate further, saying the former president didn't want him to because it would violate the principle of executive privilege, the idea that a president is entitled to confidential advice from his aides. The committee says Meadows and Trump are simply trying to obstruct their investigation.
Either you're on the side of helping us figure out why, or you are trying to stop us from getting those answers.
Meadows' lawyer is pleading with Congress not to go forward with this contempt resolution, saying that he was simply abiding by the wishes of the former president and calling the resolution a, quote, rush to judgment. George?
Making that plea, but they know where this is headed.
Yeah, it's clear, fully expected that Congress will vote to hold him in contempt. The thing that is not clear is whether or not the Justice Department will do what they did in the case of Steve Bannon and actually go the next step, which is to prosecute him. Of course, if the Justice Department prosecutes him, he could face up to a year in prison.
John Carl, thanks very much.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.